Starry Night, one of Vincent van Gogh's most famous paintings. Why? Well, partly because of the beautiful blue color portrayed here, known as Prussian blue. And therein lies an interesting story, a serendipitous discovery. Way back in the early 1700s, Johann Diesbach, a dye merchant, had a method of extracting a red dye from the cochineal insect. And he used iron sulfate and potash in his solution to do this extraction. However, he had run out of potash, so he consulted Johann Dippel, a German alchemist. And he had made a name for himself because he had produced something called Dippel's oil, a longevity product. He had distilled this out of animal bones. He thought it held the essence of life. And Dippel's oil became quite famous. Well, Diesbach consulted Dippel about potash, and Dippel had a lot of it because he had used it in making his Dippel's oil. However, when Diesbach mixed his iron sulfate together with Dippel's potash, all of a sudden it turned into a vibrant, brilliant blue color. Well, eventually it turned out that Dippel's potash was contaminated with something called ferrocyanide, and that reacted with iron sulfate in Diesbach's solution, and it produced this blue color. It eventually came to be called Prussian blue. Why? Because it was the color used to color the Prussian army's uniforms. And interestingly enough, it was also one of the first colors produced by the Crayola Company when they produced crayons. And until 1958, they had a crayon that was colored Prussian blue. They changed the name to Midnight Blue in 1958 because they thought nobody knew what Prussian meant. But there's another interesting connection to this story. Mary Shelley, the wife of Percy Bysshe Shelley, the English poet, took a trip down the Rhine River on their honeymoon. And they stopped it at a castle. And it turned out that that castle was the one in which Dippel had done his original work. And Dippel was not only an alchemist, he was an anatomist too. And he had dissected bodies in this castle. And young Shelley heard about this story. Well, they went on and vacationed in Switzerland, where the weather was very bad, and they had to stay indoors. And they had an interesting idea. They decided to try to write some mystery stories, some horror stories, because they were locked indoors. And Mary Shelley wrote a story, and she got an idea because she had visited this castle where Dippel had carried out his alchemy and his anatomical works. What was that castle called? It was called Castle Frankenstein. And the rest, as they say, is history, because young Mary wrote the story of Frankenstein. Frankenstein was the creator, not the creation, and he was never referred to as a monster in the story, always as the creation. And the idea that Mary Shelley had came from Castle Frankenstein, and you have this fascinating connection to Prussian blue and Vincent van Gogh's Starry Night.